sometime soon. So the focus right now, realistic options that can protect drivers.
Yeah, those concerns were brought up today during a meeting just this afternoon at City Hall. And News 5's John London was there.
As some of the region's top leaders pored over the design options you see here and got a better handle on the wheel of this mammoth project, they seem stymied as to how to prevent tragedies like the recent fatal rear-end collision on the Brent Spence.
Unfortunately and sadly, before that bridge is replaced, that will likely happen again.
It is a stark pronouncement. Councilman Wendell Young is pushing for new signage and netting. Yet no sure-fired short-term safety solution for the crowded and narrow lanes of the existing bridge has been identified.
But people need to know what to do if they break down on that bridge. They need to know what they do if they see a pedestrian on that bridge. The obvious fix, of course, is to replace it, but that's years away.
At least 4 years. Construction would start in 2015. The new bridge would be ready for use in 2017 or 18. Just the cost of the bridge alone runs $300 to $600 million, depending on design. And no one can say with certainty where an additional $111 million just to pay for the design work will come from. Mark Polachinski of OKI sounded the alarm today, saying we'll have to fight like hell to get this done. He says there are too few dollars in competition for too many big projects, and that Cincinnati leaders need to accelerate their passion and let the project leap from their lips at every opportunity.
If we don't handle the Brent Spence Bridge project, if we don't take care of the I-75 corridor that is within our region, businesses will find a reason not to come here.
So it appears the ride, both short and long term, across the Brent Spence Bridge gets no smoother. John London.